Hi, and welcome back. Today, in this video, we're looking at another profitability ratio called net profit margin. So let's get started. Hi, and welcome to this video on profitability. We will be talking about the net profit margin today. This is a measure of financial health in a corporation where you're measuring the strength of the remaining revenue after all of the expenses are accounted for in an organization. If you pull data from Yahoo Finance on any company, you will see that often a large bulk of expenses will fall into a category called selling, general, and administrative expense. There can be other big categories too, but this tends to be the biggest one. So how do we calculate this? The numbers for this calculation will come off the income statement, and we will use revenue or sales, which is similar to what we've done with the gross profit margin. And we also now will take the net income number. So let's take a look at what that looks like on an income statement. Using Brown-Forman, we can see we're still using the same total revenue number that we've used before in the gross profit margin video. And now we're using the net income number that it's at the very bottom of the income statement. So how do we calculate this? For Brown-Forman, we have the revenue or sales, and we have the net income, and we take net income and divide it by the revenue. That gives us a net profit margin for Brown-Forman in 2014 of 22 cents. So for every $1 of revenue that they generate, they will keep 22 cents, bottom line. And I'm comparing this to their gross profit margin, which we calculated in a previous video. And so you can see from a gross profit perspective, they keep 69 cents in 2014, but from a bottom line net income number, they keep 22 cents. And this seems to be fairly consistent for them, at least over the 3 years that we've been looking at. And so they get to keep around 20 to 22 cents, at least in these years that we can see, which seems to be pretty consistent. So they don't have anything really unusual that's happening in those years at all. Now we'll compare it to Diageo. Diageo, very similar, even though they are a much larger company in terms of revenue and in terms of net income, their margins come out to be about the same as Brown-Forman. They're keeping around 60 cents gross profit, and they're keeping around 20 cents of net profit. Now here's where it gets really interesting. When we take a look at Constellation Brands, we find something that's very unusual. I had to actually take a moment and study this one for a bit. In 2014, they had a gross profit margin of 41 cents, and they had a net profit margin of 40 cents. Now that's highly, highly unusual. I had to do a little digging on them to see exactly what happened. So what I found out was that on Yahoo Finance, the financial statements that are out there, you don't actually get every single line item on the income statement or for the balance sheet for that matter. And what I found is that they had something unusual happen in 2014 that pumped up their net profit. And so as you can see in 2013 and 2012, they only keep really, realistically, about 15 cents net profit. If you do a vertical analysis on all of these companies, you will see that cost of revenue or the gross profit that we calculated before, the cost of revenue for Brown-Forman and Diageo is around 30 to 40%, which is, they're very comparable. And their selling and admin is about the same. It's around 35, 36%. But Constellation Brands is quite opposite of that. Their cost of revenue is higher, and their gross profit and, well, their selling, general, and admin expense is a little lower, which is good, but they still only keep 12 cents, perhaps, of net income, where the other two companies keep about 20 cents, which is much better. They perform better. Now, this doesn't mean that Constellation Brands is a terrible company. It doesn't mean that they shouldn't be invested in. It just means that you should, as an investor, know a lot more about how exactly they operate and why the numbers look like they do. And so as we've seen by just doing some cursory investigations in their SEC reporting, that they have some higher bottling costs, glass costs, and they had an unusual event happen in 2014 that had to do with a revaluation that they did of an acquisition. So as you can see here on this spreadsheet, I have included a link to where you can find the investor information about Constellation Brands. Also on the link down below, you can find these SEC reports for these three companies so that if you want to practice yourself taking a look through them, because like I've said before, they're really not hard to read. And specifically, if you have pointed questions, it's actually pretty easy to find out what exactly is happening with these companies. So I hope this has been useful to you. And if you have any questions, please feel free to leave them. And I would be happy to chat with you about any questions you have about these videos. And I look forward to talking with you on another one. Thank you.